Welcome! In this video, I'm going to show you how to stream your mobile gaming sessions to Twitch from an Android phone. First off, it's important to note that the official Twitch app lets you stream your phone's camera but doesn't actually let you record your phone's screen. So if you want to stream mobile games, you'll need to install a different app. In this tutorial, we're going to use Streamlabs. The app is free and you can easily get it on the Play Store. When you open the app for the first time, it will give you a choice of different accounts that you can use to log in. Since this tutorial focuses on Twitch, select the Login with Twitch option. After you log in with your account, you'll be asked to give Streamlabs authorization to access and use your Twitch account information. You need to select the Authorize option in order for your app to work. After the login process, the next step is completing the initial setup. The app will ask you to choose which video sources you want for your stream. Check the screen option in order to stream your phone screen and the camera option if you want to have a face cam as well. After that, you'll be presented with a number of widgets to choose from. Widgets can be incredibly useful, but the functionalities they provide are a bit too advanced to discuss now. You can add as many of them as you want later. For the moment, just leave the alert box checked and tap the Done button. Next up, Streamlabs will ask for a bunch of permissions in order to be able to use your microphone and camera and display a Twitch chat bubble over your game, allowing you to easily type in the chat. You'll also notice a pop-up informing you that Streamlabs will start capturing everything that's displayed on your screen. You can dismiss it by clicking on Start Now. Make sure to check the Don't Show Again option so you don't have to deal with it every time you start Streamlabs. What you're looking at now is the stream preview. This is what your viewers are going to see once you press the big red button in the center and go live. By default, Streamlabs uses the back camera as a video source and lets it take over the entire screen. You can change it to the front camera by clicking the button on the lower left corner of the screen. Then, to modify your screen layout, press the three bars on the upper left corner and go to the editor. The editor allows you to choose which elements you want to be present on your screen and move or resize them according to your preferences and needs. The camera, screen and alert box are all on different layers represented by one of the rectangular shapes you see on screen. You can move them around with your finger or drag on the edges to resize them. You can also tap on the three dots next to each of them to display more advanced options. This allows you to choose whether you want an element to be visible to your audience and be displayed on your stream preview. I'm going to make it so that my camera and screen don't show up in the preview, but they will still be visible to my viewers once I go live. Another thing to note is that pressing the button in the upper right corner will open the Layers menu, allowing you to add new layers such as widgets, text and images, or rearrange existing ones. The layers closer to the top of the list will always be displayed over the ones below them, so make sure your screen layer is at the bottom where it doesn't cover up your camera. Now that you're done configuring everything, all that's left to do is pressing the big red button to go live. A pop-up will show up asking you to set a status and enter the game you're going to be playing. You should always do this since it will make it easier for people to discover your stream on Twitch. Once you're live, open up your favorite game and start playing. You can use the Twitch chat bubble to read the chat or send messages to your viewers while you play. When you wanna stop streaming, just look for the Streamlabs notification and press Stop All. After your stream is over, you can use Flixier to easily edit it and upload it to YouTube in minutes without having to download or install anything. You can learn more about that by watching this short video we made on the topic a while back. Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, then please consider giving it a like. If you want to see more videos like this and stay up to date on the latest Flixier features, subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Facebook and Twitter.